Let's return to our scatter plot that summarized the relationship between age and mean friend count. Recall that we ended up creating this plot from the new data frame that we created using the dplyr package. The plot looked like this. As you can see, the black line has a lot of random noise to it. That is, the mean friend count rises and falls over each age. Let's print out some of our data frame to have a closer look. As we can see, the mean friend count increases, then decreases later. In one particular case, we can see that for 30-year-olds, the mean friend count is actually lower compared to the 29-year-olds and the 31-year-olds. Now, some year-to-year discontinuities might make sense, such as the spike at age 69, but others are likely just to be noise around the true, smoother relationship between age and friend count. That is, they reflect that we just have a sample from the data generating process, and so the estimated mean friend count for each age is the true mean plus some noise. We can imagine that the noise for this plot would be worse if we chose finer bins for age. For example, we could estimate conditional means for each age measured in months instead of years. Over the next few programming exercises, you're going to do just that. You're going to create a plot just like this one with a new variable that measures ages in months instead of years. Then you'll plot the conditional mean for ages in months, and we'll compare this graph to the one that you create. To start, you're going to create the age with months variable and save it into the data frame. This variable will have each user's age measured in months rather than in years. So if a user is 36 years old and was born in March, the user's age would be 36.75. Try coding this up in R for yourself, and then once you have the code, copy and paste it into the browser and submit. Now, this is one of the exercises where the grader will automatically check your output. Don't worry if you don't get this one right on your first try. It's pretty tough. I really recommend thinking about ages and people being born in different months. How would that affect the variable age with months? Working with actual values might help you here.